Planogram Builder Tutorial 4, Introduction to the Database. In Planogram Builder, your products are stored in an online database linked to your account. There is typically one or a few users in charge of managing the database content, with the role of database administrators. If you have only one user in your account, you're automatically a Planogram Builder administrator. The other users usually have the role of standard users. They can access the products in the database for planogramming, but they can't edit the database. This tutorial is therefore only useful if you're a Planogram Builder database administrator. We'll explain how this database works. Start Planogram Builder. Click on Products. The product catalog shows all the items currently in the database. To create a planogram, you will drag items from the catalog onto your fixtures. If you're just starting with Planogram Builder, the catalog shows our sample products. By default, the products are classified by category, brand, and product line to find them easily. Now let's click on the Database tab, where you can edit the database content. In the left pane, all products are listed, one on each line. There are also filters to quickly find items. In the right pane, you can view and edit the detailed properties of the selected item. In the lower toolbar, there are various buttons to import to or export from Excel, clear the database, and create new items. Now select the first item in the list, and let's review the most important item properties. Reference is the identifier for each item. Typically, you will enter a unique product code, such as the SKU. Once entered, this value cannot be changed. Enabled tells if the item is available for planogramming. A, B, and C are customizable classification properties to group your items according to your needs. Let's configure them now. Click on Settings. Under Settings affecting all users, Item Classification Properties, you can see the three properties, A, B, and C. For each property, you can select a predefined or custom label in the drop-down list. For example, select subcategory for property B and select custom for property C. Now enter family in the text box as a custom label for property C. There are also three custom text properties available under item custom properties. As an example, enter weight next to custom property 1. Now close the settings. In the database editor, you can see how property B, C, and 1 are now labeled according to your choices. It will be up to you to select the most appropriate classification and custom properties. Note that classification and custom values are optional for each item. The name property is used for the product name. By default, the name is also displayed in the product catalog under each thumbnail. Width, depth, and height are the overall dimensions of each item. This is very important since the size determines how many items fit in your planograms. Shape is a specific property in Planogram Builder. It determines how each item is displayed in 3D. We provide several predefined shapes for standard product packaging, such as boxes, pouches, and more. It's also possible to import 3D models. The image properties let you upload pictures of your products. These images are then automatically applied onto the chosen shape to create a 3D representation of your product. The number of available images depends on the chosen shape. The item color is visible in your planograms in schematic view or when there is no product image. The behavior property tells Planogram Builder how the product is placed on fixtures, pegged, standard, on shelf, or stackable. For detailed information on database and item properties, please consult the user guide. This tutorial is now finished. Thank you for watching.